This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book: Careers in Atomic Energy by Loyce McIlhenny. Chapter 1: The Understanding the Atom Series. Nuclear energy is playing a vital role in the life of every man, woman, and child in the United States today. In the years ahead, it will affect increasingly all the peoples of the Earth. It is essential that all Americans gain an understanding of this vital force if they are to discharge thoughtfully their responsibilities as citizens, and if they are to realize fully the myriad benefits that nuclear energy offers them. The United States Atomic Energy Commission provides this booklet to help you achieve such understanding. Edward J. Brunenkant. Edward J. Brunenkant, Director, Division of Technical Information. United States Atomic Energy Commission, Drive. Glenn T. Seaborg, Chairman. James T. Ramey, Wilfred E. Johnson, Drive. Theos J. Thompson, Drive. Clarence E. Larson. Chapter 2: Today, virtually every aspect of science is concerned in some way with the atom. Physicians use radiation to treat disease. Mechanical engineers design components for nuclear reactors. Electrical engineers convert the energy of the atom into electricity. Botanists use radioactivity to learn more about plants, and zoologists use it to study animals. Chemists investigate compounds with radioisotopes. Physicists and mathematicians work out the intricate interrelations among the tiny particles of the atom. Agronomists use radioactive materials to improve fertilizers and crops, and nutritionists use them to improve animal diets. A student, you, can find your career in atomic energy in any branch of science you choose, because atomics is not a field unto itself divorced from the rest of the scientific world. The best preparation for a career in nuclear energy begins with elementary arithmetic. This preparation advances through general science, algebra, biology, chemistry, physics, geometry, and trigonometry. The aspiring scientist will be wise to lay the groundwork for his future long before he reaches college by studying as much mathematics and science as he can handle. Although many a now successful chemist entered college without knowing how to balance an equation, keen competition today demands that college freshmen have a solid foundation in mathematics and science. Even in an age of specialization, the interrelation of the sciences has made it necessary for a scientist to have at least a speaking acquaintance with areas outside his own field. A chemist, for example, may find himself involved in biology. The research interests of a biologist may lead him into physics. Moreover, English-speaking peoples have no monopoly on scientific accomplishment. Proficiency in German and French, at least a reading knowledge, has long been considered desirable and is often required of the serious scientist. In the light of modern developments, a reading knowledge of Russian might well be added to the list, and as other countries and cultures expand their technologies, familiarity with still other languages may become necessary. Indeed, a number of scientists who completed doctoral degrees years ago have recently begun to study Russian. This is not surprising, since the education of a true scientist never stops with an academic degree, a job appointment, or a significant discovery. The most brilliant physicist on Earth is of doubtful worth if he can't communicate his ideas to other people. Thus, even more important than a knowledge of foreign languages is a knowledge of one's.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.